back again up in this entertaining for you. Come for my M's, you get this double-double. Straight to your bubble in this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rubble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud, ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rain, yes, them cannons rain. Make sure you vote already when you see the game.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida. As a moment ago, the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with the Minnesota Vikings. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. This one taken just inside the 10. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Try and start this drive in the air, eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 37. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Janoris Robinson. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. They try to set up the bubble screen here. It's complete. And all the way inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds. A big play there on the catch and run. That's evidence of why you spend a high draft pick on a receiver, isn't it, Charles?
It certainly is. His ability to make plays like that, and we've seen flashes of it from him so far in his rookie season. But also, it opens things up for the rest of the offense because they have to bring their attention to him as well.
And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Daniil Hunter able to record his 5th sack of the season. Charles, a little bit of feast or famine on this drive. They moved the ball okay, but they've been sacked twice now.
And they've got to figure out how to plug that leak a little bit, right? Keep them away from the quarterback because when he's not being hit, as you mentioned, they're moving the ball well.
And he'll get inside the 40 to maybe the 38-yard line. This defense for the Vikings, they were excellent in that win over the 49ers last week.
But we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did, but we definitely need more pressure on the quarterback this week.
So it's third and long, and defensively, not a real surprise. They're in the dime. They'll set up a throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And the Vikings force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Well, a shaky start for both quarterbacks now. We had the interception on the opening drive, and now they throw it right back to him.
So does that mean we're really kind of starting from the beginning, Brandon, right? Both of them have done it, so we kind of start from scratch. Looks to me like both of these defenses have done their homework, and they're executing quite well.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Anthony Brown there on the tackle.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Second and nine now. Escaping the pressure right. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Clock down at three, and we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one sails out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25. It will. 24-yard line is where they'll spot it. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. Now Waddle on the jet sweep. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And here's a handoff out of the gun. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
Here's a second and seven. Flush to his right. This will be caught. It's Waddle. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength. Very nice route.
Back to throw now on first down. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The sack coming from big Dalvin Tomlinson. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Less than a minute to go here in a scoreless first quarter to this point. From the gun, they'll try to run it. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Second down at 5. Back to throw. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is taken just shy of the 10, and a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack and it brings up second. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. A hole to dig out of here, 2nd and 17. He'll drop to throw. And complete right side to Cook. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third. Intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had 2 interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
And the Dolphins are going to be set up with a 1st and goal as good running gets him down to about the 4-yard line. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. And sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. 2 of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
There's Fuller for a Dolphin touchdown. Will Fuller, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller. Retain their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that'll make the score 14-0. Now after after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Vikings now to start their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he wisely will throw that one away.
No grounding call there. He had a receiver near the right sideline. It was pretty clear there. He just needed to get rid of that one.
And he did have a receiver in the area, but initially my view was obstructed, and I thought that was going to be grounding, but clearly the correct call made, and that is no call.
Is that why you threw your play sheet down? Is that why you did it? Is that the flag?
You can't be giving me up. I got a lot of issues up here in the booth. They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass. They're going to look to throw. Oh, he's going to go for it all. And unable to connect, incomplete. I give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
You know, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? But everything is working for them. Every move they make works. It clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. After the incompletion, they'll try once more from the 20-yard line on 2nd and 10. He'll look to throw. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a 3rd and long. After the sack, they'll come up now, 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And indeed, that's what they'll do as they run it here. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up 4th down.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, But they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Give to Cook out of the gun. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Back to throw here. Setting up the screen for Cook. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Bears it out toward the corner of the end zone. And that is incomplete.
Thus far, they have been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one, but they may come back to it again.
And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position, really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just 3.
You know, getting the 3 turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach when he ordered the field goal. Please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Well, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A big play there for the Dolphins. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. He'll look to throw. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Person. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Person. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
So 3 plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Back to throw again. Eluding the play, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Danielle Hunter in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Well, Charles, this has been something to watch so far. This is where you really feel for a quarterback. He's been running for his life in this first half.
Brandon, that's 5 sacks already, so you know he's got to be saying, can we get some more guys in here to block, please? Because if we don't, we're going to need another quarterback.
They'll look to throw. Now a diving effort right sideline. He's got it.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. Lead is safe in this league. They decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is up to 18 now. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is taken way up at the 25. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with a 3-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, their first two drives only yielded 3 points. They might be thinking, it's time to make something happen. Push the ball downfield and try and gain some points that way. Unfortunately, incomplete.
Here's 2nd and 10. They'll look to throw here. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. The Dolphins going to take their 2nd timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number 1. The Vikings send out their punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Fielded at the 20. It takes a touchdown-saving tackle to bring him down as he goes 32 yards on the return. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. First down, he'll drop to throw it. Escaping the pressure, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. To his right, and he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. In front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. Let's go.
Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Second and three. Forced out to his left. And he'll just get rid of it. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
They'll drop to throw. And able to find Gesicki as tight end. And he goes out right around the 39. Third and four, he did just enough. I mean, just enough to move the chains.
And that's all you're looking for, right? Just want to keep the drive moving. You don't need the big play there. Just get to that marker that you described, and he was able to do just that.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. It's complete to Fuller. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. Second and five. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read. And by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. To throw again. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off by Juan Thornhill. And the Vikings are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. Pretty much everything went their way offensively in the first half, but now an interception on the opening drive of the third quarter.
As we know, the key to everything here, don't get careless with the football. The problem is you've got to stay aggressive as well. So where's the line between being aggressive and attacking and being overly aggressive? I think they just crossed it on that one.
And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, they certainly haven't been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Set up to throw. And his pass incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it at the 19-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. Janoris Robinson able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Looking to throw. He's got Fuller. And he'll go out of bounds after getting this across the 15. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Flushed out right. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And it's a second down.
It appears they found something that's working, and they keep going back to it. I guess you can actually say he has the hot hands now, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, it's one thing to hit your guy out of the backfield once, hit him a couple times. Yeah, you're right. Maybe they're onto something.
And I think a lot of that is simply, if you get it to him in space, more times than not, he's going to get more yardage than you expect out of each play.
And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Person. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. On the right side open is Gesicki, and the Dolphins are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the first and goal.
Second team.
touchdown of the night. And the Dolphins are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Sanders on for the extra point. And they open the lead up now to 25 points. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. You might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Again on first down, Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, they'll throw. Rolling to his right. And he's got this to Jefferson. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column, but as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. Behind the sticks here with a second and 15. Going to throw right side here, complete. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. The Vikings on third down. They're struggling. 0 for 6 thus far. This time it's third and 3. Out wide here for Cook. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Mike Zimmer got to be unhappy with how that turned out. And the Dolphins defense is able to hold. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless, take care of the ball on the way out.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side, and that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down.
And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. The Dolphins on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Sacks for him on the season. And I guess, partner, you call that a coverage sack.
Oh, without a doubt, because where did he have to go with the football? I know everybody wants to get on him about, hey, get rid of the football. You had too much time in the pocket. But he's scanning the field, nowhere to go, and that allowed the pressure to ultimately get to him.
Good blocking there, nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Vikings, they'll be set up well as they take over in great field position, 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on 1st down. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's 2nd down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Eluding the pressure. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And the Dolphins have got it.
All right, you've had to put up with me in this booth. I'm going to try and be simple this time and succinct. It simply has not been their night.
No, I think that fumble's kind of indicative of how this whole evening's gone, isn't it?
Without a doubt. I mean, they've tried, but nothing has ever really taken throughout the game. That's why they're down so big.
1st down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
Yeah, I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football.
Tell you what, partner, the way he's been slinging it in this one, I think he should be ticketed for a baseball cap and a set of headphones for the next drive. He's been absolutely sensational. But one thing we've both learned about quarterbacks in this league, they often stay on the field longer than you expect.
Now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Well, partner, nothing but praise for me for this offense. They have been tremendous all night long. They knew what they had to do to unlock the defense. And let's face it, this has been a master class.
And he's going to be intercepted for the 3rd time thus far. Picked off by the linebacker, Eric Kendricks. And he will take it across midfield and down to the 45. Now they get a 4th quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. Addy wisely will throw that one away. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They're looking at 2nd down now as they search for a consolation score.
You ain't doing nothing today. You ain't doing nothing today. Hey, check. Mike 21. Mike 21. Check.
And 2nd and 10. He'll look to throw again. Flush to his right. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this one is incomplete.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
They'll set up a throw. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Try it here. He's back to throw. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that will force a turnover on downs. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now they try the right side here. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Now look at this, 4th and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it.
Right there, 54, right there, 54, Mike.
He don't know no better.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for Miami, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. And they'll get another home date next week as the 49ers will come to town. Meanwhile, for Minnesota, they can't quite seem to turn things around as they fall into 2-4 now on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against the Chicago Bears. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time.
Let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bomb, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack.
Whoa.
Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gonna tackle your little man.
Get them.
Let's get activated.
Go.
Let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. Pop out, treat this block like an end zone.
What?
Score. Check it. Benji calling money my ringtone.
Hundreds.
Or blue. Put her in a friend zone. She turned on more.
Ooh.
Take one for the team. I do that for my boys.
Bread.
Game.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man. I bet we win it. Go hard or go home. It's survival of the fittest.
Let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
I done lost respect. I'm gone.